Welcome students. Now the next article from the topic AC circuit, the simple AC circuit with a resistance only. So let us consider a simple AC circuit containing a resistance R connected across the AC supply E, that is equal to E0 sin omega t. So suppose a resistance of resistor R connected to an AC of EMF E0 sin omega t, the instantaneous value of E is given by equation E, that is equal to E0 sin omega t. So this EMF is a not a constant but varies with a sin function. In case of a DC, the voltage is constant, but in case of AC applied to resistor, the voltage is not constant, but it varies between the minimum, maximum and zero values, and the instantaneous at any instant t is given by equation 1, that is E0 sin omega t, where E0 is the peak value of EMF or voltage, where E0 is the peak value of the voltage and omega is its angular frequency. Let E be the potential drop across the resistance. By Ohm's law, E, that is equal to I into R, where I is a current flowing through that resistance and R is the resistance of that resistor. So instantaneous EMF value of potential drop is equal to instantaneous value of instantaneous EMF is equal to instantaneous value of the potential drop. So from equation 1 and 2 we have IR, that is equal to E, but E, that is equal to E0 sin omega t. Therefore I, that is equal to E upon R, which is equal to E0 sin omega t upon R. But E0 upon R sin omega t has a maximum value 1, then we have I, that is equal to I max, which is equal to E0 upon R, and that I max is represented by I0, where I0 is the peak value of current and given by equation I, that is equal to I0 sin omega t, where I0, that is equal to E0 upon R, peak value of the current. So we have E, that is equal to E0 sin omega t, and I, that is equal to I0 sin omega t. So when AC is applied to the resistor, both EMF E as well as a current I, both are not a constant but varies with a sine function, as a E, that is equal to E0 sin omega t, and I, that is equal to I0 sin omega t. So from equation 1 and 2 it is clear that E and I are in the same phase and angle between them is 0, because E, that is equal to E0 sin omega t, I, that is equal to I0 sin omega t. Therefore both are in phase. So if we plot the graph of variation in I and V, suppose if we plot the graph of E, suppose this is omega t, then the instantaneous is given by equation E0 sin omega t. So this maximum value is E0, this minimum value is minus E0, and this is mean value 0. But if we plot the variation in current over this complete cycle, it is found that when E is equal to 0, I is also again 0. I show it by dotted lines. So this is the variation in current. This value is I0 and this value is minus I0. So from this graph it is clear that both E and I attains the maximum value at the same instant. They attains the minimum value at the same instant. So here we get the maximum value, here we get the minimum value, and both attains the zero value at the same instant, that is E and I both are in the same phase when AC is applied to the only AC circuit containing resistance. Now phasor diagram. So if we plot a phasor diagram, so phasor diagram, suppose there are two axes, that is y axis and x axis. Suppose this is x axis, this is y axis. So phasor is a rotating vector in an anticlockwise support. Suppose this is a voltage, that is it is length is represented by E0, and the angle with the axis, that will be omega t. Then their projection on a y axis is given by equation E0 sin omega t. The current is in the same direction. So if we plot the phasor vector, then this length is of a I0. It has a same phase angle with the axis. And if we take their projection on the y axis, then this length gives the value of I0 sin omega t. So this is indicated by this graph. That is, both are in the same direction. That is, phase difference between them is zero. So this is about the AC circuit when AC is applied to resistance only. We see that when AC is applied across the resistor, the both current and voltage are not constant but varies with a sine function, and given by equation E that is equal to E0 sin omega t, I that is equal to I0 sin omega t, both are in the same phase. Phase difference between them is zero. So this is about the AC circuit with resistance only. So we stop here.